Today I have with me Dr. Rasfiq, who is a cardiothoracic surgeon with experience of more than 15 years. We are generally here to speak about open heart surgery. So can you explain more about it?
Open heart surgery actually means any surgery that is done on the heart by either putting the heart on the heart-lung machine or arresting the heart and opening the heart and doing the surgery. So that this includes coronary artery bypass grafting, valve surgeries, repair of intracardiac defects, doing any other surgery by stopping the heart. So there are closed heart surgeries like closed mitral valveotomy, where we don't put the heart on heart-lung machine, or where we don't, even though we open the heart in that by putting a finger in and doing a valve, opening of the valve, it is not called open heart surgery because we are not putting on the heart-lung machine. We can repair a lot of defects within the heart using this open heart surgery. Like, you know, there will be defects in the ventricular septum, defects in the atrial septum, defects between the aorta and the pulmonary artery. These things can be repaired by opening the heart and doing so. The best way to approach the heart is for an open heart surgery is through the sternotomy.
Okay.
It is called sternotomy because we are opening the sternum. That is a sternotomy. So we use a saw and we cut the sternum vertically. And we spread it out using a rib spreader, a sternal spreader, purse strings around on the heart. So that we can connect the cannula into the heart. And this cannula is diverting the blood from the heart to the heart-lung machine.
Okay, so all the blood flow to the heart and from the heart is diverted
to the heart-lung machine.
Okay.
So this heart-lung machine takes care of the oxygenation and the support of the patient. And then it is given back to the aorta.
What about the surgeries which involve the heart, of course? Not necessarily all of them involve this particular procedure, right? Then means where they have to be put on the means you
heart
have to do
machine.
The whole
there are instances where we don't put on heart lung machine. There was a procedure which now many surgeons don't do. It's called closed mitral valveotomy, where you are trying to open the mitral valve, which is on the left side of the heart, through the left atrium. So in that case, your heart is not arrested. You are not stopping the heart. You are trying to open the valve without stopping the heart. That is open heart. Even though we are opening the, putting your finger inside and trying to dilate the mitral valve, but heart is not arrested, so it is not open heart surgery. This is called a closed heart surgery. Nowadays we do a lot of heart bypasses, you know, coronary artery bypass using beating heart technique. Again, we are not arresting the heart. But still we call them open heart surgery only. Even though we are not arresting the heart, it is called open heart surgery.
So
then there is a surgery called PDA, where it's a defect in the pulmonary artery that connects to the aorta. So again there we don't stop the heart. So there are few instances like pericardectomy, where you want to remove the pericardium, that is the structure surrounding the heart. So that is also, in those cases also, we don't stop the heart.
How risky is this surgery? What are the risks involved in the surgery?
When we are doing an open heart, like when you are arresting the heart, there are certain inherent risks. By far, any surgery you take has inherent risks. But in these cases, you are arresting the heart. You have to stop the heart, stop the beating of the heart. Then you have to put the heart on the heart-lung machine. That is, you are bypassing the whole systemic circulation, the oxygenation, you are bypassing the lung, and the blood is directly transfused into the aorta. So there are certain risks, like there are risks, there is a risk of stroke, there's a risk of renal failure, there's a risk of infection, bleeding, dissection. So it is a risky procedure, but by and far, over the course of years, by enough experience, we have relatively very, very small incidence of complications.
So what are the alternatives to open heart surgery, basically?
Now, open heart surgery is basically now the most common surgery is for bypass operation.
Okay. What is bypass operation in?
Bypass actually means, like, in a patient who has got, you know, the heart has got a covering of blood vessels. So these blood vessels usually get blocked over the course of time. Okay. Due to a lot of factors like high cholesterol, high BP, smoking, inadequate exercise, lack of exercise. So when these diseases involve more than two or three vessels, you have to bypass these blocks. Okay. This cannot be opened up by any stenting or any other procedure. Okay. So these patients come for surgery. So we are actually bypassing the block that is there in the coronary artery. So we are bypassing the blood from the aorta into the coronary artery.
You just told me about the bypass surgery. And you told me that open heart surgery also usually involves valve surgeries and congenital. What is valve surgery?
Many patients, because of illness like rheumatic heart disease, have disease of the valves. Okay. Basically, the heart has four valves. One is the mitral valve, the aortic valve, the tricuspid valve, and the pulmonary valve. Now, in some patients, majority of the patients usually have valve disease on the left side of the heart. That is the valves in the left side, that is the mitral valve or the aortic valve. Okay. So these valves, we either we have to replace or repair. So most common surgery is done as mitral valve replacement or aortic valve replacement. Okay. So the congenital diseases are diseases that occur in patients from birth.
Okay.
So you have patients who are born like and they have a defect in the heart.
Okay.
Like it's called atrial septal defect or ventricular septal defect or patent ductus arteriosus. So these are the common congenital defects that we see.
Okay.
So what we do is we stop the heart. We open the heart,
okay.
We close these defects,
okay.
Using either a pericardial patch or a synthetic patch,
okay.
And patients are relieved with that.
So how long does it take for the recovery from this sort of a procedure?
If it is a bypass operation, like you have scheduled a bypass operation, usually patients admitted 2 days before and patients discharged on the 7th day after surgery. So usually they take around 10 days for them to, you know, go home.
Okay.
And we advise them so around 2 or 3 months of rest.
Okay.
Same case in a patient with congenital heart disease, it is almost similar. If they don't have much complication, any complication, within 7 to 8 days they are discharged. And they can resume the normal activities by around 2 to 3 months.
Does this procedure hold a 100% success rate, or there can be chances where the procedure has not gone successfully also?
No, generally, universally around mortality rate is around 1 to 2%.
Mm-hmm.
But majority go home with no problems, usually.
Okay.
Yeah. And success rate is very high. Because of the safety of the procedure now in the
because of the advanced instruments. And, okay. So you were saying something about a stent. So what is that exactly?
Now many patients have a block in the coronary artery disease which require a stenting. That is, in a bypass operation, if there is a block, we are bypassing the block from the aorta to the distal vessel. But in a stent, because the blood vessel is blocked, you can open up the coronary artery using a wire that is passed through the defect.
Okay.
And then you put a spring-like material that opens up the vessel.
Okay.
So that is called stenting. So you're actually relieving the block by opening up the stent,
okay.
Opening up the block through using the stent.
What are the most common?
Heart surgeries we do generally are bypass operations,
okay.
And valve operations. And repair of intracardiac defects like AST or ventricular septal defect or pulmonary ductus, PDA,
okay.
Patent ductus arteriosus. So, most common congenital is these defects that I told you about, but valve surgeries are mitral valve replacement and aortic valve replacements. And bypass operation is CABG. This is the most common surgeries we do.
What are the main causes or for all these other heart ailments?
Yeah, main causes, like I mentioned before, most common cause is, you know, smoking.
Oh, okay.
Then other factors come into play, like diabetes mellitus, mm-hmm. hypertension, lack of exercise, taking increased fatty diet, you know, having high, taking food having high cholesterol content, like, you know, cheese and butter and fast food. Then lack of exercise, and that is a entity where you patients have very high cholesterol even from at a very young age.
Okay.
That is due to genetic factors.
Okay.
So there are a lot of factors that, you know, play in generating this disease.
What are the preventive measures one can take to, you know, avoid all possible heart ailments? Because of course some just come, they just happen to you.
So what you can do is you can have a very good lifestyle, have a daily walk, and healthy food, eat healthy food, avoid fast food, avoid food containing high amount of oil, and you shouldn't have these bad habits like smoking and taking alcohol and all these things. And if you are diagnosed with diabetes, get it treated. Keep your blood sugar at a good level. And if you are having hypertension, take medicines for the hypertension. And so these are the ways you can actually prevent heart disease.
In what specific way exactly, like hypertension and stress, how does it affect the heart actually?
When you are under stress, what happens is your heart rate goes up.
Okay.
Your blood pressure goes up. So your body is under, your heart is under great strain because the heart has to pump against a very high pressure. So as you are under more stress, your heart is under more strain. So they are more prone to heart disease.
The open heart surgery is absolutely necessary or not, or they can opt for something else?
Usually a patient coming for patient usually comes with a chest pain or some symptoms relating to the heart. So they usually approach a cardiologist.
Yeah.
Now the cardiologist, usually what they do is they an angiogram is taken. And in the angiogram, if there are two or three blocks and the plasty is not possible, angioplasty is not possible, these patients are referred for surgery.
Okay.
So these patients are having at least 2 to 3 blocks and 3 vessel blocks which cannot be opened up by angioplasty. So these patients are taken up for surgery. So by the patients don't really, you know, they are actually referred from the cardiologist to the surgeon, saying, I mean, the patient requires a cardiac surgery. So by the time the patient comes to a surgeon, it is already established that they require a surgery. They don't have to, you know, there is no confusion in that. And then once the patient comes to us, we schedule for surgery, mm-hmm. and patient is admitted around 1 or 2 days before surgery, and taken up for surgery on a fixed day if it's not an emergency. Some patients have ongoing chest pain, they want surgery early, or some patients cannot wait, you know, because the block is so tight that they may, you know, go into stenosis, like left main coronary artery disease.
Okay.
So these patients we take up as early as possible. It's like an emergency. So patients who are having very tight left main coronary artery disease, we immediately take up schedule for surgery at the earliest. Generally, after surgery, there's no specific therapy as such. We expect the patient to go back to his normal activities as early as possible.
And any change in lifestyle or?
No. If patient is having a very strenuous life, you know, like a very head load worker or, you know, an athlete, then we may not advise them to go for, you know, that much strenuous. But whichever profession they are in, we encourage them to go back into the same profession. So after surgery, the patient is discharged usually on the 7th or 8th day, and the patient are mobilized immediately. They are asked to walk daily. They are asked to go for daily walks. By around 3 months, they are supposed to walk around at least around 3 kilometers per day. And I have patients who goes back and is a head load worker. He does that also now,
okay.
after surgery. And I have another patient who goes and does firewood, you know, he cuts the firewood. Okay.
So basically, it's not disabling as such, means it's not, you can go back to your life as
it was. You can go back to life, but some patients have weak heart, you know, over when patients have recurrent episodes of heart attack, maybe two or three episodes of heart attack, the heart muscles become weak. So they don't contract efficiently. So these patients, even if you do bypass, they may not go back, recover to their regular activities.
Is there anything, last few things you would like to say to the people who are watching this?
Yeah, I just would like to say that open heart surgery is safe now, and mortality rate is around less than 1%. And it is absolutely safe to go ahead and do bypass operations.
Okay. And, contrary to the
contrary to the popular yeah. belief,
people just get scared when
scared about this open heart surgery.
Okay.
So I think with the latest technology and with the safety that we offer, open heart surgery is absolutely safe, and patients should be going in for willing without much
they should not be scared
about this. Yeah.
And so that was Dr. A.K. Rafiq, and till we meet again, this is Angel signing off. Thank you.